The Center of Excellence provides a major economic boost to Arkansas by attracting and retaining young, skilled professionals. However, none of this would be possible without public-private partnerships between this facility and the poultry industry. Agriculture is our state's number one industry, and the poultry industry is the largest contributor. Last year, Arkansas ranked third nationally in broiler production, second in turkey production, and eighth in egg production. It's no surprise that poultry science is so vital to our state economy. For more than 20 years, this center has enhanced the skills of scholars and faculty with state-of-the-art training and research facilities. It has helped keep Arkansas competitive in the global economy. Thank you for inspiring a new generation of industry leaders for more than two decades. Your hard work and commitment has not gone unnoticed. Again, congratulations, and have a memorable event.
The Poultry Center of Excellence is a great example of what we can do when we work together on something. This center represents a partnership between federal government, the state government, private enterprise. It is all of them working together that has made this possible. And without any one of those partners, we could not have been here today to dedicate this exciting center for the future of our students. The poultry industry is immensely important to our state's economy and in helping our state grow. Arkansas, and particularly the hills of Arkansas, were extremely poor. The hills of Arkansas, in fact, were the poorest region of our state. It was in those years that the pioneers of this industry, with grit and determination and vision, fought and worked and scrounged and imagined to try and change their industry and these hills. There were a lot of threats to their success, a lot of doubts about it. But how successful they have been is well demonstrated by the sculpture you will see as you enter the center. A sculpture of a very powerful chicken and its family.
In 1927, Robert M. Smith became the University of Arkansas's first poultry science professor. Smith conducted experiments in crossbreeding, feeding, and housing poultry. He played an important role during the early years of the Arkansas poultry industry by training poultry inspectors and developing a statewide inspection system to help control disease.
Americans not in the armed forces will get less of the common foods to which they are accustomed. But by rationing, by sharing what we have, and by using our food supply wisely, our nation at war can still support a healthy, active people.
A lot of meats were rationed. Sugar was rationed, of course. Poultry was one of the meats that was not rationed, so we had an increased supply of poultry for the American consumer and the war effort. In fact, the story goes that with all the able-bodied men in the war, that the department head, Dr. Warren Gifford, had to milk the cows, and Professor Robert M. Smith, who was the professor of poultry in the department, had to feed the chickens and gather the eggs. So, you know, it was a very small group of people that carried on during the war here.
When Professor Edward Stevenson began his research at the university in 1949, the poultry program lacked sufficient funds and facilities.
My office was in the old dairy building, which was an old fire trap that was so warped that we couldn't lock the door to our office. The floor was so sloping we had to put the desk on one side so our chairs would, swivel chair would roll toward the desk and not away from it. And I was in that 7 years, and they built the first part of the animal science building, and I moved over there.
But only in recent years has Arkansas reached its eminent place as a commercial broiler area. The state produced less than 2 million broilers in 1934. Today, its production exceeds 50 million annually, and it ranks fourth among the 48 states.
The poultry industry exploded in the post-war years. Between 1949 and 1952, Arkansas broiler sales increased over 1,000%. The industry's growth brought the Chicken of Tomorrow contest, the World Series of poultry, to the University of Arkansas campus.
The judges scored on such factors as skin texture, number of pin feathers, and meaty breasts, thighs, and drumsticks. Typical Arkansas weather prevailed Friday afternoon as 8,000 people gathered in the university's football stadium for the main program. Top prize of $5,000 went to the Vantress Poultry Breeding Farm of Live Oak, California. To the blare of the band and the cheering of the crowd, Charles Vantress received the check from Mr. Austin and the congratulations of the vice president.
Charlie Vantress, my pleasure to present this on behalf of my company, the Great Atlantic Civic Tea Company, for the wonderful job that you did in winning this first award, the 1951 Chicken of Tomorrow program. Thank you very much.
The Chicken of Tomorrow contest shined a light on the Arkansas poultry industry and the university's poultry program. The contest expanded Arkansas's ability to conduct research by providing the university farm with two modern poultry houses.
We had very limited facilities here at Arkansas, but we were able to secure the contest here, and as a result of that, got the facilities to grow the birds.
During the second half of the 20th century, the poultry industry experienced unprecedented growth. By 1985, Arkansas's annual broiler production reached 760 million birds. With several major poultry companies headquartered in the state, University of Arkansas poultry research expanded. Despite its growth, poultry science remained part of the animal science department.
Even though our poultry program had grown, we were still a secondary industry as far as the total animal science program was concerned. And poultry never really gained its due until in the 80s when we began to see that it had been the number one ag program in the state for a number of years and was going to continue to be that. And that's the beginning of how we got to where we are now.
In 1989, the University of Arkansas Board of Trustees targeted the poultry science program to become a center of excellence. Industry, government, and academic leaders gathered in June 1993 for the groundbreaking of what would become the nexus of Arkansas poultry research, the Center of Excellence for Poultry Science.
It is the perfect match. It is the one that Bill Clinton talked endlessly about in his campaign last year, of cooperation between industry, government, and facilities like the University of Arkansas. You cannot beat this for everybody pitching in.
One of the things that's representative of how government, education, and private business works together is when we think about how this building was funded. It was a combination of the industry coming together and raising money, the university being committed to making sure there's a great site and location on the campus, and three, working with state and federal officials to help fund the agriculture school, and that's one of the reasons why it got built. So that's what agriculture is all about, people working together.
The project was made possible by a partnership that involved a special grant from the United States Department of Agriculture. Senator David Pryor and Senator Dale Bumpers helped shepherd that project through the congressional process in the amount of $10 million. The grant required a match of equal dollars, half of which came from the Arkansas General Assembly through the College Savings Bond Program, and half of that was provided by the poultry industry within the state of Arkansas.
The Arkansas Poultry Federation was very much involved. Don Allen, who was head of the Poultry Federation, and Joe Yates, who had been a legislator in the state of Arkansas, then was working for the Poultry Federation. They were both drivers in helping raise funds to get this facility built.
Once completed, the 112,000 square foot building would be the largest research facility on the University of Arkansas campus.
Kids going to school to major in poultry science didn't go to the university. They went to Auburn or Mississippi State or Georgia or somewhere out there in the southeast, Texas A&M, all of whom had really great poultry science departments. And our industry felt like our university should have one equal to theirs or better. And that was the impetus for having it done, was to have a facility where our young people could get their bachelor's, master's, and PhD in Arkansas and be proud of it.
My development officer at the time, Mr. Joe Yates, and I would come and walk the slab on the ground floor practically every day at the conclusion of our workday to monitor the progress. I had the best job in the world for a person who had invested his career in poultry science.
It was vital, I think, to the overall industry that we have a place where we could chase the diseases and poultry health. And there wasn't any better place than to have just what we've got. And that's a vibrant center that has people who know the business and perform academically.
They say old men like to reminisce. Young men have vision. When I came here, we were all young men, and a lot of those people had visions, big visions. But never in our wildest imagination could we have imagined this building or a poultry industry like we've got today.
I think this is a great day for Arkansas. It's a great day for the University of Arkansas. It's a great day for the students that are in school and the fine students we'll have come after this. The Arkansas poultry industry was made up of lots of families and lots of pioneers. They're honored in the building. But this was basically kind of a farm deal in 1935 when Dad started and when the Georgias started and the Browns started and Roy Ritter. And I saw some of the Sutherland family here and some of the Collier-Wentworth family here. But it was all a family deal that got started, and all of a sudden it became a big business. It's been good to Arkansas. It's been good to our family. Thank you very much.
I think Don would also have told you that the growth of the industry and the growth of our company was going to continue to need good, well-trained people. And with the proper facility, you could have more well-trained people ready to work in the poultry industry.
The faculty in the poultry science was not large when all of this started. You can seek top established scientists, but there are also places, and it's important to have young scientists that are aggressive and are perhaps reaching into new areas, and to bring them on at the same time. Teaching faculty, research faculty, and extension faculty all working together, and that's what land-grant institutions are all about.
It was almost the culmination of what had been planned and hoped for down through the years, that we'd have a facility that would be as impressive as the people that were going to run it.
Poultry is a vital part of the economy of the state of Arkansas. Avian influenza, a highly contagious viral disease that can cause severe losses in poultry, could cause devastating losses in the state by losses of birds and economic losses.
I came on board July 1st, 1994. mostly what I do is go out and work with groups either in the county or with the industry or regulatory groups, governmental groups. Lots of short courses are taught. Those can be for anyone pretty much in the company, as depending on which short course we're teaching.
Okay, how much biosecurity is needed? Well, there is no one single plan. There are differences in each farm. Going to some place that's table eggs is a little different than going to a turkey farm, which is different than going to a hatchery, different than going to a processing plant, different than going to a grow out.
And the role that I teach there primarily is in disease prevention, which we call biosecurity, or disease recognition. I collaborate with the industry, primarily the poultry industry veterinarians. We meet and discuss what needs to be in the training, and then we'll address those points for their growers or their industry personnel.
Vast diversity of the research and development that they're doing for our industry is something that's very important. It allows us to really work with and utilize, leverage, you know, broader resources at the Poultry Science Center for research that directly affects what we're going to do and decisions that we're making in our business today.
When we make a decision in industry, it affects a lot of things. It affects the food safety, it affects worker health and safety, certainly environmental, processing efficiencies and yields, and so. But we're trying to study some of those.
I think that'd be a great project.
And most poultry companies don't have enough technical competence in all of the areas that are needed to make good technical decisions, whereas the university can provide that in a rapid method. For me personally, I've also gained a lot of value through Dr. Marzi's advisement and in my continued educational pursuits, and have been through a host of classes, of graduate level classes, and continue to pursue graduate research.
Bill Potter is Vice President of Technical Services at George's, and he wanted to get an advanced degree. And so he actually did a really good master's thesis on performance-based sanitation, which the company was using and still does. Now he's moved on to his doctorate. He's finished all his classes. He's passed the prelims. He's a candidate. We now have to focus on what his research plan will be and get that research conducted. You know, we have earnest talks about, well, what does the company need research upon that will fit the needs of both the university and the needs of the university is that you contribute to the body of knowledge. The needs of the company are that they have a desire for some research to be done. It fits their needs very specifically. And so it's actually, I think, a win-win.
You want them to have a nice
soft
surface to walk on. They have feeder lids.
The Center for Food Animal Well-Being was established in part to identify areas where we need improvements, largely research areas where we can help improve the lives of animals or more efficiently do what we do. This encompasses things from bird health, physiology, nutrition, not just the behavior of the animal. In addition to that, it has an outreach component. We're expected to help educate the general public and provide information both to scientists and to the public about food animals and their care.
One of the things that we're really looking at is when we're doing welfare research, we're looking to measure stress in those birds in non-invasive.
We have had an annual symposium on current issues and advances in animal welfare.
On selecting animals for different.
We couldn't have done that without the support of the local industry.
John Kirk Skeels Poultry Health Laboratory was developed as a laboratory central to the poultry industry in Arkansas to be able to work on cutting-edge problems with infectious diseases or health related to poultry and poultry welfare, poultry production.
Kirk Skeels came to the university about the same time that I did. Worked together for about 22 years. He was a disease specialist. We did a lot of vaccine work at that particular time. Dr. Hargis and his students and workers over there have really carried on the tradition of Kirk Skills. He would be real proud.
This lab is really well known in the area of probiotics, and I think it's one of the best places where you can learn if you are really interested in that area.
Floramax started as a defined lactic acid bacteria-based probiotic. The product has to be delivered in the drinking water or by spray application in the hatchery. So many PhD students, master's students got their degree doing research with Floramax. The science was produced by our graduate students and the undergraduate students that work in this laboratory. Without them, we are nothing.
When we're successful, we are directly impacting the world's food supply. We're directly impacting animal health and well-being. We're reducing animal suffering. We're contributing to productivity of the poultry industry and poultry farmers, and we're contributing to the economy. All those things for me are motivating factors.
If you take corn and soybean type diets, we've always got variation in the quality of these ingredients. And so one of the things the allied industry, the poultry allied industry is now using is they have a lot of these enzymes that are commercially available that they sell. And so all these poultry integrators are always trying to find out which ones work, which ones don't work. One of the key things that comes up is how do we use these enzymes? Because what they're all trying to do is get more value from their ingredients. So this is what we do a lot of work with. The allied commercial feedstuff industry has been very supportive of me, mainly because of the tools that we now have assembled here at the University of Arkansas. We now have metabolic chambers that we use. We put these birds, breeders and brawlers, in these metabolic chambers, and it's very, very sensitive. We have the opportunity to look at heat that's expended when we use these enzymes in their feed. And so these enzymes will show us how they're working at the maintenance level as well as the production level. We feel like we've got the most sensitive system in the world for evaluating enzymes.
What this machine does is measure how much oxygen they are consuming, because oxygen is very important to oxidize the nutrients that they are eating. Nutritionists, they want to know how much they need to give to the birds. So with our research, we hope that we can give them a calorie number for them to formulate, for them to give to their birds in order to keep them healthy and also in a good production.
The experience that this processing plant can give to a student is really the basic understanding of that processing of that live bird into a food product. Regardless of where the student ends up in a processing environment, live production, sales, or other type of career, the understanding of this operation is still very important, so that they can relate to their other colleagues in other work situations. My research focus is in the meat quality area and poultry processing, and so the processing plant is very critical to my program because this processing facility really simulates what is in the industry. And that's important when we're trying to conduct studies and make conclusions that will be applicable to the industry. We can prepare students to go out and work in the industry and really help solve their problems.
I'm over the University of Arkansas Poultry Farm Research Hatchery. I believe the hatchery we have here is
as good of a hatchery as you'll find at any research and interest institution in the country. Most of the companies that are here at some point or another, I've done some collaborative work with on incubation and hatchability. I have the opportunity to go a lot of different places, see a lot of different hatcheries, not only here in Arkansas, but across the U.S. and then internationally as well. And so when they ask me to come in and look at their hatchery, it's a different set of eyes, that have seen different things and seen different situations. My collaboration with the integrators, with the poultry companies, as far as incubation, is greatly depending on their needs. I don't want to just go and answer questions for me. I want to answer questions for them that are going to make them more productive.
1.5% of broilers, they become lame during the production. So that means a lot of chicken cannot reach the market ages. We have to withdraw them. We are trying to understand the cause of lameness and how we can reduce it, prevent them. My role as a microbiologist is trying to characterize the bacterial communities in the bone of the lame bird. We have a collaboration with among different scientists, eventually the reducing the lameness caused by the bacterial cause.
We can look at basically mitochondrial function within the intact cell. Mitochondria are the powerhouse of the cell, makes energy that's needed for all the cellular functions. We found that there was better mitochondrial function in birds with high feed efficiency. Low feed efficient had greater oxidative stress that appeared to be due to defects in the mitochondrial electron transport chain. All of this could play a role in the cellular basis of feed efficiency. The industry is very, very good at, they operate on a very small margin, so they're very efficient as it is, so anything we can do to help them maintain efficiency will help them be sustainable in the future, and we all have a high quality protein source.
When I first started out, it wasn't uncommon to hear regularly about outbreaks in which producers could lose 20-30% of their birds due to mortality. That's a fairly rare occurrence these days. Coccidiosis, that's been my focus of research. It's a very important disease. Almost every poultry farm can have the infection at a low level, subclinical level, and so there's a need to control it. The disease has become more intractable in some respects, but it's not causing those heavy mortalities that people used to be see in the past. The primary beneficiary, of course, of our research is the poultry industry and the individual farmer who's growing the birds. I mean, he doesn't want to lose birds. And so that's where our goal is aimed. I think that if you were to ask the poultry industry how they evaluate this disease, they would say it's less important than it used to be. And that's a consequence of the research that's being conducted.
My main project is actually a biomedical model for an autoimmune disease. I have lines of chickens called the Smith line chicken that get an autoimmune disease called vitiligo. Vitiligo is a pigmentary disorder whereby the immune system is attacking the pigment cells.
So now we have a vitiligo score of 5 bird, another rooster. And this one here, you can see the new feathers right there are completely white.
We keep collecting feathers all throughout 20 weeks of age, and then we go back and look at the profile of vitiligo development. I consider the Smith line one of the best models to study autoimmune disease. If you understand how you can get the immune system to kill your own pigment cells, then we can use those mechanisms to also address melanoma. Birds don't seem to get melanoma, but for the human, as a model for human disease, this provides a lot of insights in that direction as well. I have a variety of projects as an immunologist specializing in poultry immunology. We're looking at very basic aspects of the immune system, ranging from what we call innate immunity, which is sort of the innate defense system that birds have, which is very important for their early survival, and then also adaptive immunity, which is the specific immunity.
The one area that we believe we can have an impact on the industry would be to continue our studies on stress in birds. There are times when birds go through a lot of stress. It happens once they're hatched, for example, and the chicks have to be vaccinated. After they're vaccinated, they are boxed and then shipped. This is a very stressful period of time, and so it's one of the areas we're looking and examining. High levels of the stress hormone in chickens, it's corticosterone, can kill neurons in certain parts of the brain. And we've been successful in studying two receptors that we feel are critical in this stress response. And these are vasopressin receptors. And we feel that this can, in fact, benefit the industry if we can know better how to control these high levels and keep them lower during these periods of constant, what we call chronic stress.
We've had a great relationship with the center since, I think it's 1998. We've done a little over $3.5 million worth of research work with the various professors and students over there. Do great work with us in terms of research on genetics and research on practical topics such as nutrition and bird management.
In the 1980s and 1990s, a problem associated with cardiopulmonary insufficiency, called ascites, posed a severe threat to the broiler industry. Susceptible birds had lungs that were too small and immature to handle the blood flow that's needed to support rapid growth. Broilers that were susceptible to ascites had low blood oxygen levels that we learned to record using a pulse oximeter. If you were doing this in a broiler, you would basically use this probe on the wing between the radius and the ulna to detect a small pulsing artery there. This tool allowed the broiler genetics companies to select birds that had better blood oxygenation. Gradually, the genetics companies reduced the susceptibility of broiler lines to ascites. And this is just one example of how the Poultry Center helped the industry solve a very important problem.
We have four houses on the farm. We grow about 20,000 birds per house for Simmons Foods. We are a contract grower for them. The university employs students to work on the farm part-time. We also have a production class that comes out here once a week, and there's four groups, and they're each assigned a house, and they have to take care of the birds that are growing in the house.
The Savoy Farm is a great resource for the student population. It's hard work to be a grower, and to understand that before you become a service tech or begin working in an operation, respect for that front end of the process is important.
There's 24 birds in each pen, and we weigh the birds once a week, then weigh the feed to see how much feed that they've eaten.
It gives us the ability to run pen trials in an environment that's maybe more controlled or different than the environments we might run pen trials in our own organization.
The advantage for the center is that they can run tests very easily in a real world situation in a large broiler house. The students are running those pen trials at the same time they're taking care of the houses of broilers and getting that real world experience that many of them wouldn't have otherwise.
We very much appreciate the relationship that we have with Simmons. they provide us with all the opportunities and the flexibility to run trials, to evaluate equipment, and to train students while we're growing commercial birds for them. And that is truly a unique opportunity. It provides us a teaching opportunity for students in the form of welfare. We can teach welfare, we can evaluate welfare.
The farm's a really good tool for students because it really gives you a perspective on, is this what I want to do? Most people find that they really fall in love with it.
We're an agriculture company, we're an R&D company, but we feed the world, and we take that responsibility very, very seriously. So we're looking for people who want to feed the world with us.
I'm Will Hewitt. I'm a freshman at the Poultry Science Department at the U of A. I worked with Cobb Ventures this summer. I did a lot of data and research. Worked with the tech service guys. They were out in the field. I would weigh birds, measure birds, do a lot of different measurements. It really has helped me as far as networking goes. My professional network has grown greatly because of that.
We've really built a strong bond with the faculty and the students there. We've, since 2013, hired around 29 students coming out of the program there that are working for us in the tri-state area here.
I tell the students, go work for somebody. Find out what a job is about. You don't have to follow your passion to be successful in a career, but what's important is to bring your passion to the career opportunities at hand, then that's going to open the doors for success.
My name is Peyton Gilbert. I'm a master's student in poultry science. I want to get my master's and eventually my PhD in poultry nutrition. When I first started looking at grad school, obviously my first thought was, should I stay at Auburn or not, because it's where I did my undergrad. This was the first place I really came and interviewed and toured, and I loved it, immediately loved it, and knew that this would be a good fit for me.
One of the key things for any industry is having great people to hire and select from. The center does that for us. It has, in most recent years, expanded its ability to attract students and graduate world-class students that we then can have the first pick of here in Arkansas. And it's been a big advantage for the industry in that regard.
This is my first research trial. My first trial as a grad student. These are turkeys, so this is a feeding trial.
Collaborations with turkey companies like Butterball are an important component of what we do. We try to help them find solutions for challenges that they've had, whether it be water quality, nutritional challenges, or even some management issues.
Tracheal plugs are kind of a problem in turkeys in the industry, and this particular trial is working with an iodine-based feed. They're trying to see if adding additional iodine into the feed will cause an increase in tracheal plugs.
If we look out between now and 2050, so say a student is about to graduate, during their working career, we're going to have to basically double food production on this planet. Same amount of land, same amount of water, twice as much food. That is a daunting task. That's a huge responsibility, but it's also an awesome opportunity. It's so important for us to have a great relationship with the center, spend time there, help the students understand the practical application of what they're learning in school and how it will apply and what their career opportunities are.
If you go pre-professional, such as graduate school or vet school or whatever, you're going to need to have the faculty connections to go to the next level. If you go industry, you're going to need to be active in the club, so you're in constant engagement with the folks from the industry.
I was really impressed by the department itself, by how many different people you have working in the department. We have like people that are specialized, it seems like, in every aspect of poultry, and that's really cool.
Thank you.
think that gives me a larger experience base to really decide what I want to do.
All the professors are super nice, super friendly, super helpful. If I have any questions, I can email them pretty much any time of day and they'll get back real quick. They seem like they're very knowledgeable and they're out there for the best interest of the students and not for themselves.
I'm Ellie Solberg. I'm from Minnesota and I'm studying poultry science this year at the University of Arkansas as a freshman. I chose the University of Arkansas because of the great poultry science program, and I had looked into animal science and other programs at other places throughout the state and Minnesota and other places, and this just really stood out among all of them and made me really enjoy poultry science a lot more.
The center's done a wonderful job around attracting great talent to the poultry industry. There's always great research that's done there. The education's very practical, but you got to pour all that into people. And the center has done a wonderful job attracting very, very high quality students into the program that then come into companies like ours and help us grow our businesses.
This is my fourth and last year of PhD. I'm finishing in December, I'm graduating, and next year I'm joining Cobb Bantress as a breeder nutritionist for US and the world. So I think I couldn't get that job if I haven't been here.
The U of A has one of the best undergraduate programs in the country. There's just so many opportunities. In Northwest Arkansas, there are multiple job opportunities, and it's just a career with a very bright future.
You definitely need to look at the poultry science program. With the number of people we're going to have to feed, the chicken meat is going to be the number one seller most likely, and there's so many opportunities in the field.
I think that the center's biggest contribution is likely drawing excellent students out of that large university population and equipping them with skills to succeed in our industry, and those practical, not theoretical, skills that we need every day.
Faculty at the Poultry Science Center are very focused on our needs, the needs of the industry, both now and in the future, and are getting ahead of that with curriculum and research and development to train and educate, the future managers of our industry.
It's a natural relationship between research, innovation, and then most of all, it prepares young people to come into the agricultural community in the state of Arkansas, because we've got a lot of great graduates from the state of Arkansas and the university that make our business a very good business.
The Poultry Federation has, over the years, been a major scholarship donor. For the last 3 years, I think we've raised over $100,000 each year for scholarships for students who are interested in pursuing a career that might lead them to the poultry industry. And I would say 99% of those students would be poultry science students who attend the University of Arkansas.